Kinetic theory of gases. The weightage of this lesson is 4 marks. Two very short questions or one short question will come from this lesson. Let us know the importance of this lesson. The random movement of molecules in a gas is explained by kinetic theory of gases. Mean free path. Let us consider a molecule. These molecules collide with first molecule during its motion. After that, it collides with the second molecule. Like this, it will make multiple collisions with the different molecules during its motion. But here, this is the first distance before first collision, and this is the second distance before second collision. That means the average of this distance covered by a molecule between two successive collisions is called mean free path. Mean free path denoted by lambda. Lambda is equals to 1 by root 2 n pi d square, where n is equals to number of molecules per unit volume and d equals to diameter of the molecule. What does kinetic theory of gases explains? Kinetic theory of gases explains the following concepts. First one, it explains molecular interpretation of pressure and temperature. It explains different laws, gas laws, such as Boyle's law, Charles law, and Avogadro hypothesis. And it explains specific heat capacities of many gases, which contains monoatomic molecule, diatomic molecule, polyatomic molecule. Now, behavior of gases. Gases at low pressures and high temperatures approximately satisfy a relation between their pressure, temperature and volume, which is given by following equation, that is PV equals to CT. Consider it is equation number 1. This is the universal relation which is satisfied all gases, where P, V, T are pressure, volume and temperature respectively, and C is equals to NKB is the constant. It varies with volume of gases, where N is the number of molecules and KB is Boltzmann constant, which is given by 1.38 into 10 power minus 23 joule per Kelvin. Now substitute C equals to NKB in equation 1. Then we get PV equals to NKBT, which can be written as PV by NT is equals to KB. It is same for all gases. Consider there are two gases, P1, V1, T1, pressure, volume, temperature of first gas, and P2, V2, T2 are the pressures, volume, temperatures of second gases, and N1, N2 are the number of molecules of first gas and second gas. then we can write P1 V1 by N1 T1 is equals to P2 V2 by N2 V2. From this equation, we can conclude this relation is satisfied by all gases at low pressure and high temperature. Justification of the Avogadro's hypothesis from equation of gas. Avogadro hypothesis states that equal volumes of all gases at equal temperature and pressure have the same number of molecules. Consider the equation PV by NT is equals to constant, and if P, V and T are same for two gases, then N, that is number of molecules, is also same. According to Avogadro hypothesis, number of molecules per unit volume is same for all gases at a fixed pressure and temperature. Avogadro number is denoted by Na, where Na denotes 6.023 into 10 power 23, it is universal value. Perfect gas equation. Perfect gas equation is given by PV is equals to nRT. PV is equals to nKBNAT. Since universal constant R equals to kBNA, where P comma V are pressure, temperature, sorry, value, and T is absolute temperature, and small n is number of moles, and R is universal gas constant. And one more thing, KB, Boltzmann constant, Na is Avogadro number. This equation tells about the behavior of a gas at a particular situation. If a gas satisfies this equation, then the gas is known as perfect gas or an ideal gas. Real gas deviation from ideal gas. A perfect gas satisfies the perfect gas equation, that is PV equals to nRT, or it obeys gas laws such as Boyle's law, Charles' law, at all pressures and temperature. But what about real gas? At low pressure and high temperature, real gas behaves like an ideal gas. We have a question. When does a real gas behave like an ideal gas? The answer is at low pressure and high temperature, real gas behaves like an ideal gas. Let us define the basic laws, Boyle's law, Charles' law. Boyle's law. At constant temperature, the pressure of a given mass of a gas is inversely proportional to its volume. That is P proportional to 1 by V. PV is equals to constant. That is K. Charles' first law. At a constant pressure, the volume of a given mass of a gas is directly proportional to its absolute temperature, that is V proportional to T. Therefore, V by T is equals to constant. Charles' second law. At constant volume, the pressure of the given mass of gas is directly proportional to its absolute temperature, that is P proportional to T. Therefore, P by T is equals to constant. The difference is between Charles' first law and second law. Charles' first law relate the terms volume and temperature, keeping pressure constant. And Charles' second law relate the terms pressure and temperature, keeping volume constant. Dalton partial pressure law. The total pressure exerted by a mixture of ideal gas is the sum of partial pressures of each gas. That is P equals to, here P represents the total pressure exerted by a mixture of ideal gases, is equals to P1 plus P2 plus P3 and so on plus Pn, where P1 is the pressure exerted by first gas, P2 is pressure exerted by second gas, P3 is pressure exerted by third gas, and Pn is pressure exerted by nth gas. Pressure of an ideal gas based on kinetic theory. Consider a cubical vessel with each side of length smaller than the volume of the vessel, V equals to L cube. Consider it is equation number 1. Let m be the mass of each molecule and n be the total number of molecules, and V is speed of each molecule, and Vx, Vy, Vz are velocity components of molecule along x, y, z axis respectively. Then we can write V square equals to Vx square plus Vy square plus Vz square. Consider it is equation number 2. Suppose a molecule move from PQRO phase to ABCD phase and collide ABCD phase elastically. Now in this case, the momentum before collision of the particle P1 equals to MVX, and momentum after collision of the particle or molecule P2 equals to minus MVX. Because the molecule move along negative x direction after collision. Now let us find the change in momentum, delta P equals to P2 minus P1. Substitute P1 value, P2 value in this equation. Therefore, delta P equals to minus MVX minus MVX equals to minus 2 MVX. Now, in this case, the molecule imparted momentum to the phase ABCD is equals to 2 MVX. Equation number 3. Now, let us find how much time taken by molecule to travel PQRO to ABCD and again ABCD to PQRO. The total time taken by molecule, delta T, is equals to total distance from PQRO to ABCD, L, and again ABCD to PQRO, L. Total L plus L, 2L, distance traveled by the molecule by the speed of molecule Vx. So delta T equals to 2L by Vx. Consider it is equation number 4. Now the force exerted by molecule on ABCD phase according to Newton's second law, Fx equals to change in momentum by time taken. As you know, change in momentum is 2mvx by time taken, 2L by Vx. So 2 will get cancelled. So we get Fx equals to mvx square by L. Consider equation number 5. Now the pressure exerted by a molecule on ABCD phase is given by Px equals to force by area, that is Fx by area of ABCD, which is equals to Fx by area of ABCD L square. Consider it is equation number 6. Now substitute equation 5 in equation 6, then we get Px equals to mvx square by L divided by L square. Therefore, Px equals to mvx square by L cube. As we know, L cube is nothing but volume of vessel. Therefore, pressure is equals to mvx square by V. Consider it is equation number 7. Similarly, we can write Px value, Py value, Pz value. Py is equals to mvy square by V, and Pz equals to mvz square by V. Consider these two equations as equation number 8. As we know, the pressure exerted by molecules is same in all directions. That means the px value, py value, pz value, all are same. So we can write px equals to py equals to pz equals to p, say. Let us add these pressures. Px plus py plus pz is equals to p plus p plus p. Therefore, 3p is equals to px plus py plus pz. Therefore, p is equals to px plus py plus pz by 3. Consider it is equation number 9. Now, substitute px value, py value, pz value in this equation. That is, substitute 7th equation, 8th equation in 9. Then we get p equals to mvx square by v plus mvy square by v plus mvz square by v whole divided by 3. Now take common m by 3v in this equation, then we get p equals to m by 3v into vx square plus vy square plus vz square, which is equals to m by 3v v square. Consider equation number 10. Since v square equals to vx square plus vy square plus vz square. Now, divide equation, multiply and divide equation 10 on right hand side with capital N. Therefore, m capital N by 3v into v square by n. Now, p is equals to mn by 3v vrms square. Consider equation number 11. Here vrms square is equals to v square by n. Vrms square is equals to vx square plus vy square plus vz square by n. Therefore, vrms is equals to root of vx square plus vy square plus vz square by n. Here v is nothing but rms velocity. The abbreviation of rms is root mean square. Therefore, p is equals to, we get m by 3 n v rms square. Consider it is equation number 12, and here small n is capital N by capital V, and equation 12 represents the pressure of an ideal gas based on kinetic theory.